Was Paul sick in his body? If yes, was it God who put it there to keep Paul in check or to test Paul? Well, a careful reading of the verses of scripture will identify the root cause of the thorn. The thorn. Because Brother Paul says, it is the messenger of Satan. The messenger of Satan. God didn't send it. The thorn in the flesh was sent by Satan. Was this thorn sickness? The thorn in the flesh. Well, the term thorn in the flesh implies opposition and persecution from human beings. Thorn in the flesh, not sickness and disease. Further references that establish that is Numbers 33:55. Numbers 33:55. Those you let remain of them shall be as pricks in your eyes and as thorns in your sides. Joshua 23:13. Joshua 23:13. There shall be a snare and a trap to you, and a scourge in your sides, and thorns in your eyes. Judges 2:3. Judges 2:3. But they shall be as thorns in your sides, and their God shall be a snare to you. So Brother Paul's thorns in the flesh was a figure of speech for persecution. A figure of speech for persecution and affliction he faced in the preaching of the gospel. The thorn in the flesh was a figure of speech for persecution and afflictions that he faced in the preaching of the gospel, not sickness or disease. Look at what Brother Paul says in 2 Corinthians 12:10. 2 Corinthians 12:10. Therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in necessities, in persecutions, in distresses for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then am I strong. And of course, you know, God told him my grace is sufficient. Because for every minister of the gospel who is in distress and persecution to the threat of his life, there is enough grace from God to sustain and preserve him. My strength is made perfect in weakness. My grace is sufficient for thee. Because Brother Paul says, I besought the Lord thrice to take it away. And God said, we don't take away persecution. We don't take away affliction. But in the persecution, my grace is sufficient for you. Are we in the building? Yeah, so the thorn in the flesh was not sickness. It was persecution and affliction for the sake of the gospel that Brother Paul was called to preach. Now let's look at a case or a scenario here. In Galatians 4:13. Galatians 4:13. You know how through infirmity of the flesh. This is Paul speaking. I preach the gospel unto you at the first. Through infirmity of the flesh. So when did Paul preach that gospel to them at the first? Well, this region was called Galatia, which constitutes of Derbe and Lystra. Derbe and Lystra. Okay, and Antioch. So let's examine the first time he came to them and how he came to them. Acts 14:6-10 and then 19-21. It's quite a read. Acts 14:6. They were aware of the situation. They were aware of the situation, made their escape to Lystra and Derbe, cities of Lycaonia and the neighboring district. Verse 7. And there they continued to preach the glad tidings. Verse 8. Now at Lystra a man sat who found it impossible to use his feet, For he was a cripple from birth and had never walked. Verse 9. He was listening to Paul as he talked and gazing intently at him and observing that he had faith to be healed. Verse 10. Shouted to him, saying, stand erect on your feet. And he leaped up and walked. He leaped up. Paul didn't make him leap up. The man leaped up and walked. Because the recipient will have to receive intentionally and deliberately. It is not forced on anybody. You receive healing by faith and you act like people that are healed. You receive the healing by faith. When we release it to you through the teaching of the word or through prayer, and then you act like those who are healed. Look at verse 19 to 21. Acts chapter 14, 19 to 21. And there came thither certain Jews from Antioch and Iconium, who persuaded the people, and having stoned Paul, drew him out of the city, supposing he had been dead. Next verse. Howbeit, as the disciples stood round about him, he rose up and came into the city. And the next day, he departed with Barnabas to Derbe. 21. And when they had preached the gospel to that city and had taught many, they returned again to Lystra and to Iconium and Antioch. In this account, Brother Paul was stoned and he was left for dead for healing a sick person. The next day, with the wounds, he continues to preach and he came to them. That's the ailment, the infirmity, the thorn in the flesh. He was stoned. He didn't fall ill because he was preaching with the wounds. He was preaching with the wounds. Now that said, Paul never taught believers to see sickness as the works of God. Never. Neither did Jesus teach sickness as the work of God. The work of God is the healing of the sick. Now, like I've been saying in the last few days, medication is not a sin. There's nothing wrong with medication. We should never despise the natural cures prescribed by doctors, which are the wisdom of God too. We should always also know where sickness comes from.